dance by water beneath the Mexican sky. Drink some margaritas by swinging blue lights. Listen to the mariachi play at midnight. Are you with me? Are you with me?
Hey Guam photography YouTubers. Today I want to look at the two different Leica cameras. One, the M9 or the Leica M-E that has a CCD sensor. The second camera is the Leica M Type 240 that has a CMOS sensor. And pretty much overall, I want to look at the files that's coming out from it for sharpness, skin tones, different colors the files produce, and kind of do a direct comparison between the image quality that comes from it. And today we have our model next to me.
Hello, my name is Genica Phan, and on the last video we did a YouTube together, it was a Sony G Master 85.
So let's get started and let's check out the differences between the two Leica cameras, comparing mainly the CCD and the CMOS. Talk about the two physical appearances of both cameras. Here, Genica's holding the Leica M-P Type 240. In a sense, is the same as the Leica M Type 240, except this has a 2 GB buffer and doesn't have the red dot. This is the Leica M-E, which is very similar to the Leica M9. This doesn't have the USB like the M9 and the preview frame lever like the M9. This is a little bit smaller. The width is about 37 millimeters compared to 42 millimeters, so this is thinner. This has a very low res screen at the back, like 220, 240K dots. The back of this camera has 920K, almost 1 million dots for the screen, so it's very high resolution. Other than that, this can tether USB in studio if you have the multifunctional grip. The USB on the M9, you can't really tether unless you have like a hack program to tether, but so the M-P Type 240 is more, has more options for you to use in studio, and especially when previewing pictures that you take on the field like we're doing now. This is very easy to see and easy to zoom in to check for sharpness. This is actually still very hard. To make sure both cameras produce similar RAW files, the settings on the camera have been the same. Both is an aperture f2 when I take the portrait shots. Both have the same shutter speed of around 2000. The ISOs are the same at 200. White balance is auto, and I'm shooting in both RAW and JPEG. Also, the metering on both, it shouldn't matter, but both for the MP240, it's centered. And this, I think, just has a classic metering, the Leica M9 ME. So pretty much, I expect to get similar results based on exposure, but we'll see. The only difference is 18 megapixels for the CCD sensor and 24 megapixels for the CMOS sensor. So technically, the CMOS sensor should produce more detailed files since it has higher megapixels for more detail. The lens I'm using on both cameras is the Leica 50mm Summicron APO. This lens is legendary. Yes, it is very expensive, up to over $7,000 brand new. This lens is sharp from center to corner, and a lot of people say that this lens gives a medium format look, meaning it is very sharp, wide open, and the transition from sharpness to bokeh to the blurred background is very smooth. And a lot of people do prefer this on the Leica M-M Type 246 monochrome camera. I just want to make sure that I'm getting everything in focus, so when Genica is done with her wardrobe change, I'm going to stop this down to 5.6 to make sure everything's in focus. And basically the purpose of this review is just to look at the files, the colors, the skin tones from both the CCD from the ME and the CMOS from the MP 240. I know the sensors don't create the color themselves, It's the analog to digital converter and other things that play, but I just want to see which camera is best for those that do have a budget. If you have a smaller budget, is Leica M-E still good enough in 2017? Or if you have a higher budget, never mind a 8-year-old camera and just get the newer Leica M Type 240. I know the M10 just came out, but M Type 240 is going for good value on the used forums. Yeah. Okay, good. On three, 1, 2, and 3.
Are you real? Are you with me? Are you with me?
We just got done with the photo shoot, and from my observations, the M-P Type 240 seems to have an off white balance. It looks like on the screen a little bit greenish, whereas the Leica M-E or M9 has a better white balance. It's really hard to say which has better skin tones out of the raw files or which has better sharpness, but we have to look at it on the computer. And I forgot to mention that both cameras are set to, I think I did mention it, DNG and JPEG, so I want to see out-of-camera JPEGs as well. Genica, how did you like the photo shoot today?
It was good, just really hot.
Yeah, it was raining the last couple of days, and all of a sudden today the rain cleared up and it's like super hot. Thanks for watching.
Peace.
On the left-hand side, we have the Leica M-E, or is labeled here the Leica M9. Right-hand side, we have the Leica M-P Type 240. Both files are unedited. If you notice, the white balance on the M9 is very cool. Okay, let's check for sharpness. Very sharp on Genica's eyes. And if you notice, she zoomed in a little bit more because the CMOS sensor is 24 megapixels and the CCD on the left is 18 megapixels. And we are zooming in 1:1. Let's look at the next set of pics here. Okay, this is the JPEG. Okay, this is the RAW. Okay. M9 is on the left-hand side. Again, white balance is much cooler, but I notice you can make it look like the M Type 240 files by just adjusting the white balance to be warm. So let's do that now. Just at about 50, 200. Okay. And if you notice, adjusted, they look very similar. Both sensors, both cameras are very sharp. This is shot wide open at f2. Even if it's reported otherwise, it's shot at f2. Okay, good. Let's look at the next set of photos. This is the M9. M9 will always be on the left-hand side. Let's look at skin tones. Very sharp. This is using the Adobe profile. Skin tones, they look very good on both cameras. And notice if you try to use the embedded profile for the Leica M9 ME, you scroll down under develop, you go to camera calibration, profile, check that, click on embedded. Her skin looks too red. If we check out the M Type 240 file and click on embedded for it, the overall picture is very saturated in colors. So I just left it at Adobe standard. Okay, I did a 5.6 comparison shot here, like an M9. Okay, like an M9, like an ME. I did my best to try to make it the same exposure, but the clouds are always moving in front of the sun. 5.6, super sharp. But if you notice, there's a lot of moiré in her hair and not that much in the CMOS sensor. And there's a lot of moiré on her black top. And you don't see that in the CMOS sensor. That's what I noticed. Next thing I want to look at is JPEGs. Two examples here. I actually like the JPEGs out of the M9 better. Everything was set to standard, but it seems too contrasty or too dark with the M240 files. Okay, let's look at one more set here. This is a JPEG, yes. I just think the JPEGs look underexposed for some reason. I'm liking the JPEGs better for the Leica M9. So if you're in the market for a Leica camera, if you are on a budget, you can get a used Leica M9 for about $2,600. If you don't really need live view, if you don't need the better LCD screen at the back, if you don't really care that much for the shutter sound, then get the Leica M9. It's a really great camera. That's what I own personally. But if you do have the budget, maybe about $3,500, $3,600 on the used market, and you want the better LCD screen, you want the better sounding shutter sound, you need live view. If you need to go high ISO at 3200 and above, then get the Leica M-P or even the Leica M type 240. All right, thanks for viewing this video. Please subscribe.